after my family again.
For what?
What's going on? This is the Low Key Cave, Keyshawn Nyles' YouTube page, aka Mr. Low Key. We back with another Snowfall review. This is season 4 Snowfall, episode 3. Let's jump right into it, man. We seen the aftermath of a lot of things that was going on with from episodes 1 and 2 with Franklin dealing with everything that's going on between Man Boy and Scully. And then we have everything that's going on between Oso and Teddy with the ramifications of the sheriff dude at the in Mexico at the sheriff office, like trying to make them pay a whole lot of money just to look the other way to let them move their shit through Mexico or whatnot. But like I said, I'm seeing some people I see saying like the season feels different, you know, with God rest his soul, RIP to John Singleton, man. I know John Singleton did help create this show with somebody else, but I mean, I don't think he wrote a lot of these episodes. Like, he had a lot of good writers in there, and I'm still seeing a lot of those good writers. And I'm not necessarily hearing people saying the show is not good, but I'm just hearing them saying it feels different, and that's a good thing. Like, we are watching these characters grow from season 1 to season 4, and everything that's happening in between. So I'm not expecting none of these characters to be acting the same way they was acting where they at now. But just seeing where everything is going right now and seeing how Franklin is trying to deal with this cop, you know, this white cop, you know, Andre's so-called friend, you know, whatnot, that he's paying every week, you know, and everything that happened with the cop, you know, coming to address his daddy at the homeless shelter and whatnot, and you see how Franklin is dealing with situations now the way you think he would have dealt with on past tense. And even him, like, the way that cop approached him and the way he approached that cop and the way he's talking to him, like on some bossed up shit, it's like, yo, like this Franklin, like, I mean, at the same time, you just seeing how cold Franklin is now, man. Like, dude is just about trying to make sure he taking care of his organization and his family, his inner circle, and that's it. Like, the way he sit there and was talking to, like, the book people, like, you know, the whole book owners from the bookstore and whatnot, like, you know, trust me, I got you. You don't worry about it. Nothing. It's all good. I got you. And then come back like, yo, your store gone. You keep the money. You know what I'm saying? She like, yo, this bookstore been in our family forever. And he like, y'all got to move. Like, on some Rick James cold-blooded. Like, for real. Like, man, to me, I'm enjoying that, though. Like, I don't like, of course, man, you don't want to see Franklin, like, hurting people like that. You know, some kind people. And, I mean, he was going there basically finding out shit about Teddy at this store or whatnot. And just the way he's dealing with shit now and the way he's trying to handle it and the way his mama is coming in, helping him, making sure he get in touch with these certain mayor people, the way he's trying to climb up the ladder as far as the politics going, everything that's going on, like, man. It's just showing you how much we've come, how far we've come with these characters. Like I said, Franklin has been to jail. Franklin been shot. He had this kill. He killed one of his best friends. Like, come on, man. And then you got everything going on with Leon and him not getting that good product from Franklin now. And you see how he just dibbling and dabbing with whatever he got now and selling it throughout his projects or his territory and what he got going on. And you see the situation with Wanda, man. And everybody's like, oh, shit, is this where Wanda gonna try to get her shit together? Is this, like, Wanda losing a tooth? Is it making Wanda wake up or whatnot, man? But what I'm really enjoying with this show, man, is just, that's why I kind of give it that comparison to The Wire and giving it somewhat of that realistic nature. Like, it's not all the way The Wire because it's got some shit that, it just ain't gonna happen, in my opinion. That shit just not gonna happen. I mean, but you never know. Like, some of this shit is loosely based on some shit. It's loosely based on Free Ray Ricky Ross story and the whole thing with the CIA and them bringing drugs into the black community. But just like I said, seeing how the way they are depicting and showing the effects of the drugs, man, like they did with the last season. And now you see the way they coming in with the whole gang thing and them showing the ramifications of how that shit just how quickly it dissolved the neighborhood, man. You watch season one and see how it starts off. You see how people riding their bikes in the neighborhood, the ice cream truck coming through and whatnot, and now coming into, like, this basically, like, I ain't gonna say this 4 years later, this might be more than that, depending on how the timeline of the show is going, but you just see how shit has changed throughout that neighborhood, man. And you see how they're showing you how the drugs coming in and how that shit just basically decapitates the hood, takes the whole neighborhood's head off, man. But it's just dealing with everything Franklin has going on with his inner circle and just the way he's dealing with shit, man. Like I said, it's just I'm enjoying just seeing how far they've come and just showing how these characters have changed. Now, to me, I enjoy Franklin, don't get me wrong, but I'm going into my favorite part of this episode, which was Teddy and Oso. Yo, I know my boy Oso was going to get his back, and I didn't even think it was going to come this episode. I thought this shit was going to kind of be some shit that was going to kind of go on. And I still think it's going to be some ramifications for what they did, but, man, this shit reminded me of a movie called Sicario. If you haven't seen it, it had a little bit of that John Wick, Teddy coming in there with that John Wick shit. But if you haven't seen a movie called Sicario, you definitely need to check it out. It's called Sicario. It's directed by, it's written by a guy named Taylor Schreiden. I think he's doing a new movie with Michael B. Jordan called Without Remorse. But I just wanted to throw that in there real quick. Check Sicario out. The reason I mention that movie is because of the ending of this episode. Man. The way Teddy came in shooting, because I'm thinking, when them people started getting shot, I'm like, oh, shit, they must got like 4 or 5 people. No, nigga, that's just Teddy coming in with the goddamn silence on that shit. Boom, 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 boom. I'm like, yo, they coming in not playing. And even before we got to that, you had Oso going into the club looking for old buddy. He find that motherfucker just whooping his ass, throwing his ass off the roof. And you know, they got the other people, you know, they wrote the $100,000 in blood on the floor. Oso, this motherfucker carve $100,000 on his forehead. Like, come on, man. Like, this is what I'm saying, man. Like, I'm enjoying, like, look how these people have came. Like, don't get it twisted. Oso, I think, was already like that type of dude. He was already on that type of time. But Teddy and Franklin, look at where they are now. Look at them. The coldness of them. And Teddy, like, man, Teddy is always almost in that realm where you kind of don't want to be rooting for him sometimes. But then you like, oh, I fuck with Teddy. Because he almost got this weird loyalty to him, to the people he rock with and he working with, even with Franklin. And now, like I said, the last time I did the review, you see kind of that relationship he has with Oso. And like, man. And him coming out telling Oso, like, I'm CIA. And them going through doing what they doing. And you like, damn. But like I said, man, the ending of this episode, bruh, Teddy and them coming in with that shootout, that shit was like some straight ass, like, action shit type shit. Like John Wick, a little bit of John Wick, but it still kept the realness, the little realist formula of it, man. And then Oso sitting in the car with the goddamn sheriff sitting his ass in there. That's why I'm like, oh shit, so they got him early. They didn't even wait. I thought this shit was gonna drag out a little bit, but I still think it's gonna be some people that's gonna come in, whatever's gonna go in. This shit is not gonna go away. I don't think so, but maybe it is. I don't know, man. But that was my favorite part of this episode. Like I said, I enjoyed Franklin and everything and what they had going on, but that was my favorite part of this episode, man. But like I said, I'm really enjoying this season. I kind of, when it first started, I came in like, I wonder how they going to do this without John Singleton, man. I was worried too, because like I said, John Singleton being Boys in the Hood and all of that, you know he was on hands-on with this, series, Snowfall. You know he was hands-on with it. So I feel like he has people that's going to cherish what he wanted to build and what he wanted to keep going. And I just feel like they ain't left off on nothing. I'm excited. It's tense for me. I don't know where. I'm always looking out like, where's Scully going to come from? Where's Scully going to come from? Because I'm still waiting on that nigga to just pop up. You don't feel them vibes. You don't feel them vibes. Look at them goddamn roaches. That nigga Scully. Bro, shout out again to DeAndre Bonds, man. The guy playing Scully, bro. You know that's the nigga off The Wood. All them classic movies, man. I hope he get an award for this, man. Because he definitely still in these episodes that he in, man. But yeah, man. Y'all hit me in the comment section. Let me know how y'all feeling about this new season of Snowfall Season 4. Let me know if y'all looking forward to the rest of the season. Let me know which characters y'all enjoying the most out of this season. Hit that like button. hit that subscribe button, man. This is the road to 100 subs, man. And once again, I want to give a shout out to everybody that's viewing my videos, man. Shout out to everybody that's viewing me, man. I really appreciate it. And shout out to all my new subscribers and everybody that's been subscribed me since day one. Shout out to all y'all, man. We're going to keep going. We keeping it going. I got some more content coming. But shout out to all y'all, man. We out.
What's he saying here?
What is this? What are you doing?
Making a big mistake.
Snowfall, all new Wednesday.